Pretty much, and actually they have an annual singing festival which brings singers from all over Ireland and Scotland, Isle of Man and further afield.
Right.
So it's
are you still picking up songs around the area?
Still learning stuff, never
is
stop,
so?
Never stop.
Because that's one thing about the pair of you, as I said, your repertoires are absolutely huge.
Well now Len has more songs than I have.
You have more tunes than I have.
I have more tunes than Len has.
Right.
No. And sometimes, Paddy, you know, you find... You know, singers that have no interest in music at all would hate to hear a tune, and vice versa. And you have musicians, and I'm sure Sean, you'll agree with that, who play music and they hate to hear a song. I mean, it's the death knell of a good music session. But Len and Sean, and well, I'd say most of us here, like to hear both.
But in your part of the country, both went really hand in hand.
Ah, yes. I think in nearly every part of the country that was the way in the old days.
Mm-hmm. Well, why is there then such a divide between the musicians and the singers?
Well, I think that's an artificial one and a fairly recent one, because most of the people that I met were into stories, dancing, singing.
Right.
The whole gamut, you know.
Oh, yes.
And of course, everybody would go into a house and there'd be a song. And there'd be a few tunes.
A few stories,
right.
Or whatever.
And the stories as well.
A few stories and recitations. And tea and bread and drink, all right. That. You know?
But of course, the pair of you, you're just actually back from America.
Yeah.
We are indeed.
I just got back from Boston now, yeah.
So you're playing with the Boys of the Lock and you're playing with Skylark, two groups, and yet you're teaming up together. Why is this?
Why not? Also, why is the Pope a Catholic?
It's a reunion, it's a sort of a reunion thing. We used to go right away back in the 60s and 70s, so it was just an idea Cahill had, and I was delighted to accompany him to America, and we really had a great time, just like old times.
Seeing as that you've come all the way, will you sing us a song?
Well, I'll do my endeavour, and I'll sing you a song called Seán na Dtír a Ghlenadh, which is usually associated with Munster, and a certain Colonel John O'Dwyer from a place called Aherlow in County Tipperary left Ireland in the early part of the 17th century, and there's a song about it. It's an Aisling, or a vision poem. And this is an Ulster version, and Cathal's going to give me a wee hand here on the timber flute.
Yeah, it's a Chinese flute.
A pleasant morning, sunshine all adorning. I heard the horn give warning, wind burns mellow call. Bangers flee before us, wun kong start lower us, guns in the ringing chorus. Amid the echoes all, the funks runs high and higher, horsemen shouting nigher, the maiden mourning by her, geese that are all gone. Now they fell the wide wounds, farewell home of childhood. Oh, Seán na Dtír a Ghlenadh, your day is o'er. It is my sorrow sorest, woe the falling forest. The north wind brings me no rest, and death is in the sky. My faithful hound tie tightling, never sporting brightling, who would make a child laugh lightly with tears in his eyes. The antlered noble hardened, stangs are never pardoned, never chase nor startened. From the Winnie Hills, if peace came but the small way, I would journey down on Galway, and leave though none for always my erring of the ills. Oh, my woe and ruin through sinless death on doing came not o'er the strewing of all my bright homes. How want on summer's morning I watch the spring returning, the autumn leaves a-falling, and the dew on the woodland hill. Now my land is a-plunder, for my friends a-sunder, I must hide me under branch or bramble screen. If soon I can none save me by flying from foes who crave me, O Shanna, dear Glanna, death will come between.